Hi. In this video, I'm going to talk about the usage of factor formula, right? The usage of factor formula, which factor formula can using to convert the addition form of a trigonometry or subtraction form of a trigonometry into a product form, right? Into a product form. So this is the listed factor formula, right? So as you know that the formula for each factor formula here, you can rewrite in the two form, right? You have two types of formula in each factor formula. So you must view the video for the first part, okay? Factor formula, where I derive the factor formula, right? So you have to view the video. As in the video, I tell you that the alpha plus beta is A, right? And the alpha minus beta is B. Right. I listed this out because all of this is given in your final examination. Alright. So, right, yeah, then you have after you solve this simultaneous equation, then you will have alpha to be A plus B over 2 and your beta to be A minus B over 2. Right. So means for example, for this formula I can rewrite it as sine A to be what? A to be alpha plus beta, alpha plus beta, so plus cos, the beta will be, the B here, will be alpha minus beta, two sine cos, and you know that A plus B over 2 is alpha, and this one will be beta, right? You can rewrite this into this form, right? When you need it. When you need it. So, but for this case, you look at this. You want to convert the following as a product of sine and cos. As a product, you know. So, means that from here, you see that from addition, means that the sine, and this will be your A, right? This one will be sine B. So, which formula to apply? So, I'm not going to think that I'm going to use this formula, right? So, I'm going to use this formula because directly I know that A is 5 theta and B is theta. So I can, using that formula to convert this from addition become product form, product, darab, tambah menjadi darab. So very easy, I apply in this way. Yeah. So I show you. So sine A plus sine B. So according to this formula, A plus B is equals to 2 sine cos A plus B over 2. A plus B, which is 5 theta plus theta over 2. And the other one will be cos A minus B over 2. So means 5 theta minus theta. 5 theta minus theta over 2. Then you have convert it become product form. Sine 5 theta plus theta. 6. 6 over 2, 3 theta. Cos 4 theta become 2 theta. You see? This is the product form, addition, tambah, ini darab. So convert become, addition become product form. So this is the meaning of convert the following as a product of sine and cos. So when you want to do this type of thing, you must using factor formula. Alright, let's look how to solve question 2. How to? Alright, let's look at question 2. Cos 8y minus cos 6y, right? So you can select the formula from the list here. You have sine A plus cos B. This one should be sine B. The formula should be sine B and also sine, right? I make a mistake here, sorry. So let's say sine A minus sine B, sine A plus sine B, sine A minus sine B, cos A plus cos B, cos A minus cos B. So now you're looking at this one, cos A minus cos B minus. So this will be your A, right? And this will be your B. So cos A minus cos B. So you look at here, right? This will be the selected formula, cos A minus cos B. So which is equals to, just apply the formula, negative 2. You have 2. Sine, sine, right? Sine, sine. 1 A plus B over 2, 1 A minus B over 2. Means that A plus B, so 8Y plus 6y over 2. The other one will be 8y minus 6y over 2. Then done. You have applied the formula. So negative 2 sine 8 plus 6, 14. 14 over 2, 7y. Sine 8 minus 6, you have 2. 2 over 2, you have y, right? Can you see that? Subtracting, adding form, become product form, multiply, right? Of two trigonometry. So, all right, let's look at the third examples. So I hope you try by viewing this video, you try, and then at the same time you learn from the video. All right, let's look at sine 7 alpha minus sine 3 alpha. So sine minus, can you see that? This is the formula, sine A minus sine B. So, okay, just apply. So this is your A now, and this is your B now. So sine A minus sine B. So you were getting 2 cos sine, right? 2 cos sine. So the cos will be have A plus B over 2, 7 alpha plus 3 alpha over 2, right? A plus B over 2, A minus B over 2. So for sine, A minus B over 2 will be 7 alpha minus 3 alpha over 2. Rewrite, you have 2 cos. 7 plus 3 is 10. 10 over 2, 5 alpha. And this one you have sine. 7 minus 3, you have 4. 4 over 2, you have 2 alpha. Right? So you have convert become product form. Alright? So same thing also for this. Okay, I doing now. So will be cos 15x plus cos 5x. Cos A plus cos B. Become product form. You know that the question asks you to convert, become product form. So then you know that this will be the formula, right? Cos A plus cos B. So means 2 cos A plus B, 15x plus 5x over 2. The other one will be 15x minus 5x over 2. Then you will have 2 cos. From 15 plus 5, you have 20. 20 over 2, you have 10x, right? And cos here. So 15 minus 5x, you have 10x. 10x over 2, you have 5x. So then you have, this will be the product form. For this addition form, you have convert become product form. So this video, I'm talking about using the formula sine A plus sine B, sine A minus sine B, cos A plus cos B, cos A minus cos B. I'm talking use about these four formula. But in another video, the third video, I was talking about how to make use of the second type. For each formula, you have two form, right? How to use the second form, right? So as you know that for the first form, sine A, cos A, or the AB, you are using to convert addition or subtraction to product form. So of course you need to come back here, you need to go backwards. So it means when you go, there is a way of coming back. So when you from product form to addition form, then we need to use the second form of the formula. All right, so let's see the next video.